do you want to shift? That is the first question that comes to everyone's mind, because we have been doing the Torin intraocular lens with the traditional marking systems for a few years now. Most of the surgeons who were doing it were pretty happy with the results that they obtained with that. Then why do you need to shift? We all know that torics is all about precision and accuracy. These are the two benchmarks for a toric guide. You have this very typical patient sitting in front of you, and you are telling the patient that, look, you've got a significant amount of astigmatism. If you go in for a non-toric lens, you're going to end up with a significant astigmatic correction for distance, which means you will have to wear glasses both for distance and near. And he says, I don't mind wearing glasses for reading, but I want good uncorrected distance vision. So this is a typical patient that we are looking at. And so by opting for a toric lens, we should with confidence be able to tell him, look, I'm going to give you a lens which will give you excellent uncorrected distance vision, but you still have to wear glasses for reading. So this is the typical scenario of a patient in whom you are doing toric. Now in this scenario, when you have errors in your mandrel marking or errors in your alignment, in spite of the best toric lens available in the market today, the patient can still end up with errors and you can have an unhappy patient. We all know that even a small degree of tilt can produce, you know, undercorrection of the astigmatism, and the size of the rexus is again very important for long-term centration of these premium lenses. And these are the factors which are taken care of by the new technology. So what are the changes that we are looking at? We have heard in the talks today morning, and we all know that the Vision cannot capture the axial length as of now. So you have to depend on your lens star or your IOL master, whatever is available, to calculate the axial length. The capture of the keratometry is supposed to be much more accurate with the Vision, and that is why it gives you much more predictable results. So basically the surface topography is the key. The way the surface is mapped for you, the way the cyclotorsion is taken care of, the way the angle kappa is measured, the misalignment between the optical and the visual axis, these are the things that make the Vision a much more accurate machine and gives you much more predictable results. So the new software which Saikat was talking about, the version 3.1, which will also give you the Varex formula, and it gives you better results in the post-operative period. The previous speaker has told you how the things are done in a Vision. I'll just brief you. You have a keratometry done here, which is based on the reflections, and then you have the capture of the limbus, the pupil and the vessels in the limbus. And then you go on to the IOL planner module, where you can choose the intraocular lens that you want to implant and do all your incision and calculations. And then finally you have the module which is attached to your operating microscope, the MIC, which guides you during surgery. So the IOL planner, as we all know, you can choose the formula, you can choose the type of lens that you want to implant. If you want to add on the LRA calculators, that can also be done. Marking is something which, you know, has always troubled me a bit, because in a busy OT, it's difficult to come out in between and do a marking. Most of the markings are done by my fellows or my juniors. Sometimes it is smudged, sometimes in one case it gets delayed by the time this theater, the patient comes to the OT, it is not very clear. So this is one big advantage, the way I look at it, where the Vision scores over the other systems. The another important thing with the Vision is you can sync it both with your femto as well as the centurion. So if you, all your calculations with the femto can be pre-planned using the Vision planner, and then you have this surgery pilot where you have the patient registration, it guides you to do the rexus, you can choose the size of the rexus that you want, it guides you towards all the incisions. And then during surgery, if you want, you can switch it off, because sometimes during surgery, you keep on showing what is the aspiration rate and flow rate and things like that. If you find it disturbing, you can switch it off. But at the end of surgery, you can use it for aligning your toric and also to find out whether it is exactly centered, especially in multifocal lenses. You also have this Bluetooth foot pedal with the Centurion, which helps you to link it directly with the Vision. And with the movement of your foot switch, you can align this. Now let us look at two typical videos. These are just simple videos. This is the original technique that we were using. you have to make the pre-op markings, which is usually the horizontal meridian, and then once the cataract is removed, then you use your marking system with the ink. And quite often it's slightly difficult to exactly position the three dots of the toric lens with the ink, and you end up having a bit of problem there. Now compare it to the Varion, you have this entire marks on you during the entire surgical procedure. You can choose the size of the rexis that you want, and while aligning the lens, you know exactly where the toric axis has to come. What I usually do is I remove the cohesive viscoelastic from under the intraocular lens first, and then make it almost exactly aligned to the axis that the Varion shows to you, and then remove the sodium hyaluronate from the anterior chamber. So you are almost aligned there, and the final fine tuning can be done either by nudging the lens slowly with your hydrodissection cannula, or you can use an infusion along the main port and use your dialer from the side port to just nudge the lens into position. So at the end of surgery, you know exactly where you have positioned the lens, and you can be pretty sure that the calculations that you have done are exactly like what you want. So what is new with the Barrett? We have the most exciting new arrival, which the Alcon has been telling me for the past 1 or 1.5 years. You know, like it's going to come today, tomorrow. Now I Sarkar tells me end of the year. So we are waiting eagerly for the 3.1 version of the Varion, and which would probably give us a lot of extra edge for calculating the lens powers, especially with the Barrett's formula. And we also have the entire Barrett suit, I believe, in the 3.1, which gives you the Barrett's 2K, especially for the post-LASIK eyes. And it captures the total, even the posterior corneal astigmatism is calculated in the new formula. So better capture of cyclotorsion and better calculation of the surgically induced astigmatism also. So we are looking forward to this software, which will help us a lot. At the end of almost all the video talks that I have given, because I happen to be the first user in Kerala, there are a lot of people asking me what exactly did you find different with the video and how it has improved the results. So let us put things in a proper perspective. It's a very important tool in preoperative planning, but then you can't use it in eyes where people who can't sit on the slit lamp properly, those who can't fixate properly, very old patients, sometimes you find it really difficult. And since it cannot calculate the axial length, it's really not a replacement to the lens star or the IOL master. You still have to use those devices for your axial length calculation. Incision location has to be pre-planned. So you need not depend on the machine to have your incision location. You can say where you want your side port, where you want your main port, everything. But then you can choose the steep meridian and calculate it accordingly. And whatever you choose is what the machine points towards you during the time of surgery. Any size of capsule or excess can be obtained, but of course, sometimes in very small pupils it gets a bit tricky. All the parameters displayed during the surgery are optional. As I mentioned before, sometimes it can be a bit troubling. You can switch it off. One of the most important things in the video is the toric intraoperative marker, which I found it very, very useful, and that reflects in the good postoperative results that you obtain. IOL centration, extremely important in multifocal lenses, but many often you find that the lens, once you put it in the back and surgery is finished, and then you put the centration marking, you find that the lens is slightly off-centered with the visual axis, because the Varion actually captures the visual axis and not the optical axis, and that is exactly where your multifocal has to be centered. So if you can nudge the lens to the centration square or centration marking on the visual axis, it gives you much better post-operative results as far as the multifocals are concerned. It's linked to the centurion, and the lensx are of course good additions, and the Varion has definitely helped me to recommend the premium lenses, the toric and the multifocal, and even the toric multifocal lenses with a lot of confidence to my patients, which is also reflected in my post-operative results over the past few years. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Sai, for those excellent insights into tips.